god. I'm going to be walking you through my chair split routine. So this is my proprietary this is my proprietary routine for how I do my weighted chair split. So this is all very secret until now, so you're going to be watching me actually work through this. It takes about an hour or so. At about 2 o'clock, you'll be seeing the final product, but it's a very unique way to warm up for this. So first thing is drugs. We need those. So... For the splits, I take a little bit of Finibut. I don't have anything to measure it with. So. And there's a link to another video where I discuss this. It's an anti-anxiety sleep aid. It just helps calm you down. Rhodiola rosea is one of my favorite supplements. Take for anything. It's an adaptogen. It just fucking tastes like shit, though. God. Theanine helps calm me down. Obviously, the Khmer coffee. Alright, so what is this calming down thing? Alright, so the splits is like this. With the splits, when you're doing a weighted split, it is like a max effort, so there's a lot of strength involved. Because I'm about to hold weight over my head in a very compromised position. But I find that, unlike something like a max deadlift or squat, where you can kind of overdo the stimulants and still be okay, with this, you have to also have a calming component involved, because there's a lot of relaxation involved in the movement as well. So it's kind of like a cross between, like, you know, strength, relax while you're bouncing in position. So that's why I'm taking things like theanine and Finibut, and then... half a painkiller, because I feel pretty good today. I don't need a whole one. A quarter of a nicotine tablet, so that's 1 milligram. Aaron. And that's my stack for the chair split. A lot of you guys think I use cocaine, but I really don't.
Just pat your whole body down with it.
Yes. what is it? It's through the butt. What is that one? It's
The heroin balloon?
No, I don't. Oh. I forgot. It's a
suppository
cocaine. No. All right, so the very first exercise I do when I warm up for this is, well, this is a rad roller, but basically thoracic extension. So I have quite a few number of rollers here. All right, different sizes, and then the peanut. So I'll actually spend about 15 minutes loosening up my spine, because that's one of the most important things for when you're doing, well, any split. Because if you think about it, if you look at it, there's a lot of the upper body is having to stay upright the whole time, fight that. So you're flexing the glutes and staying upright the whole time. And if I don't loosen that up, the whole movement just will not work. So I spend an awful lot of time loosening that up. So I'm just going to start with this straight pipe right here. Oh! And... Okay, so thoracic extensions. Oh, my back is popping and everything. It feels great. I actually do this one about every day. Well, not about. Every day I do this stretch at some point. It's probably the most important stretch I do for everything I do. And there's a few different ways you can do this. The first is just cross your arms here and keep your head forward, keep your lower back on the ground, and just move your lower back, upper back like this. See? Move up and down. I also like to extend overhead. This will stretch the chest too. Since this is also exercise in a way, I do want some carbs. Like a pump. I like that shit. And amino acids. Because the other stuff was like for calming me down and giving me kind of like alertness. And this is just like straight up energy or something. I don't know. It's just like carbs and some amino acids. That's all I want. I don't want much.
And now you chug.
Yep. Needs a little bit more in there, but get the idea. All right, so in between sets of the thoracic extensions, I do some squats. So just easy squats. Because if you think about it, the squat is a flexibility exercise, and the chair split is a very strenuous, strength-involved flexibility exercise. And so this is just kind of waking up my muscles, just kind of like saying, hey, get ready to be strong. And it's just activating a good pattern in my nervous system. In fact, look, you're going to get a groin stretch right here. See that? Just kind of pushing out a little bit. Watch this. This is pretty cool. This is something I do too. This is called a sling. It's made by Slingshot. That's Mark Bell's company. It's called a hip circle. So you can also emulate this with like a short band, like a short resistance band. But this is, it's like luxury. It's a nice product. It's good. I like it. And so what it forces you to do is force your knees out when you squat. So you can kind of get used to that motion, activate the hips. So, boom, I'm having to kind of open up like that. And that's actually some muscles that are involved in the side split. When you're in it, you're actually kind of having to actively do that. So this is just, since this is the very beginning of a longer warm up, it's just kind of hitting that. And then other things you can do with this, just anything that's going to loosen you up is going to be helpful for getting ready to do like a maximum split attempt. Puzzle mat. Don't reveal your secrets.
Discipline,
puzzle mat. You can't tell they're puzzles. Very good tolerance. Okay. And then, let's go to the short plank. And a weight. Here's a way to level up your thoracic extensions. Set the weight here. Boom. Sit down. Push up. And then the best way to do it is to get to this point.
The only side effect is bleeding internally.
Okay. I'm not done with that yet either. I gotta go further with that one. All right. Notice that, well, we're 17 minutes into this shit. I haven't even done any stretch. You notice that? It's the way this shit works. All right. Oh, product placement, right. Okay. I like the hot plate. Best $17 I spent all year.
So I thought about getting one of those actually.
$17, man. Little you don't kitchen. Have to worry about your cup of coffee going cold. Alright.
I gotta have the child's temperature anyways, you know that.
Well, you can set it to a child's temperature. There's
a setting.
There's boiling and pussy. Alright, so you're somewhere in between there. Further on the pussy side there. Alright, so when you're doing the chair split, it's like this, right? Okay, so the sitting stance, it's a popular martial arts stance for like emulating the strength you need right here. And look, notice how my upper body's having to do this crap. That's what thoracic extensions are helping with. So I'm just gonna go ahead and switch to a powerlifting squat. Like this, really wide. And then I'm gonna go down. You kind of feel that groin say, hello, waking up now. Push the knees out. That's what the hip circle is there, trying to emulate that. So they're not doing this, they're doing that. Not this, that, upright. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. So, very wide pause squats with an acceptable amount of weight. You don't want to go too heavy. Well, you can, but you wear yourself out. I'm working the flexibility more here than the strength. So I want to focus on the time. It's taking a little bit of time. And I can't have that time if I go too high in weight. And if it's not enough, my body won't care. Here. All right. Can you guess what exercise I'm doing next, Corey?
The chair split.
Yeah, I'm ready. Let's do it.
No warm-ups.
No warm-ups. Screw you. Going back to
the short stack? Oh.
Short stack. This is a rad roller. It's just essentially the same thing, only it's got a notch for your spine. It's pretty cool. I like it. That's why I have one. It's really good to travel with.
Is it TSA approved?
Yes. I'm trying to figure out what's in my bag. Oh, I know what it is. Every time I pass through a scanner in the airport, you know, I have to walk through and do this. You know, the x-rays? Yeah. Every time I do that, they go, whoa, because everything lights up on the screen. They have to pat me down from head to toe. And I think what's causing it is the amount of muscle I have.
I was going to say, that's a whole new level of yoked right there.
Yeah, one guy had said, it must be the muscle. I don't know. I'd be interested if other bodybuilders have that problem, because I can't get through those things without like a frisk and a pat me down and a hand job and everything.
I was going to say, it might just because you're so damn good looking.
You know, this thing, this is the peanut. Trying to find the spot. Ah! Notice how I'm using like structure around me to push me into certain positions in the stretch? You need to do that with all your stretches. Use your environment to your advantage. Is that like a Pokemon principle?
I was going to say, sometimes you can use a super friend.
Oh, yeah. Step on me. Do it. No, seriously. Yeah, stand on me. Oh, that feels good, actually. Like, shift over a little. Oh. Like, do the same thing. So, yeah. There we go. And then I can combine it with that. All right. You got your balance, Corey?
I hope so.
Life is good. Life is really, really good. Internal bleeding. Get off. Okay. I'm serious about this back warm-up shit. You gotta do it, or you'll fucking not be able to do whatever you need to do later. Whew, okay. Good for now on that. Alright, this is my next stretch. I am actually, 20 minutes into it? First groin stretch of the day. use the bar and just kind of pull myself down like a sumo deadlift, except for I'm not really deadlifting. I'm just kind of pulling myself down and using my elbows to kind of push out. So it's kind of like this stretch, only I'm kind of using the bar to kind of help me pull me down and using the arms to kind of push out here. So it's kind of like a simultaneous, and then I can kind of use the bar to, because if I'm trying to straighten out, I might fall backwards if I didn't have something to hold on to. There, boom. Super stretch. Always use tools, equipment, and your environment to your advantage to situate a stretch to push the human body in positions it can't achieve alone. So, here we go. I'm gonna start doing this. Still getting that back. This is still a ground stretch. Take that squat. There we go. Now, look at the clock. What is it? 23:40. Now I'm going to rest and do nothing for 3 minutes. No, seriously. The rest period over?
It's been 3 minutes.
Oh, okay. All right, let's get back to it then. Oh. Oh, okay. Has it really been 3 minutes? What did we say?
We said 3 minutes, right? Well, 2:24. I guess it's only been a couple minutes. Maybe one.
I feel rested, though. I feel rested. Okay, so get right back to it. Right back into it. But you need to actually include rest sets in your warm-up and in your workout. Like, actually look at the time and time it and force yourself just to, like, do nothing during that time, because if you fill up your warm-up and your workout with too much restless energy as your rest periods, you will fail at life. So, still warming up and growing here. I'm going to go ahead and go back into this one. Pump it out a little. Alright. Let me explain something real quick. What's going to go on here in a second. When I do a side split or a chair split, there's two things happening at once. There's simultaneous relaxation of certain muscle groups. Hence the relaxation compounds in my pre-workout stack. And certain intense activation of other ones. So, for example, upper back has to be like this when I'm in the side splits. The butt, in order to keep this position, has to contract. So my glutes have to be activated. You do that through, like, you know, getting your butt activated in traditional exercises. And then the groin has to kind of grip and maintain, but it's also got to kind of relax to balance. And the hips right here, more like relaxation, they just have to get out of the way. So certain muscle groups have to be kind of like, they have to be mute, and other ones have to be like yelling. That's coordination. So what I'm going to do is, this might be kind of a, I don't know, more like a rehabilitative exercise, but it's called a bird dog, and everyone's seen it. I like to do it with the hip circle on. It's a little more difficult, but I'm having to start stretch my groin, but I'm also having asshole. I'm asshole trying to get my my glutes to start firing, so just kind of like this one. I'll do a few sets of this, and then I'll probably go back to thoracic extension a second, and then back to the groin stretch. There is no, like, in any of this I do, there's no, like, set reps, sets, time. It's just by feel. So some days I need more, some days I need less. The exercises always kind of stay the same. The sequence always kind of stays the same. So it always starts with thoracic extensions, some squats, with some activation exercises, that stuff doesn't change. How many I do depends on, you know, how I'm feeling. Some days I feel fucking great, some days I don't. Right now I feel decent, so, you know, it's about average. I want this.
Chug.
Put a little bit too much water in that, maybe? All right. So now I'm going to start doing my favorite groin stretch. It's called a Cossack. See where I can do this where you have room to see me. Can you see me okay?
Mm-hmm. Let me get back over here. Unless you're going to do it.
Just right here is good.
All right.
All right, so Cossack stretch. This is like a traditional Cossack stretch. You got the foot up. But if you notice, when I do my chair splits, my feet are like this. So I'm actually kind of stretching this. It's an aesthetic thing. Everything to a certain value, everything to a certain extent has an aesthetic value to it. So if your chair splits are ugly because your feet are like this or some shit, then fix it. And, you know, if I'm doing a prerequisitory movement that's similar to the movement, I want to do it in a way that's as similar to my end goal as possible. So when I'm gripping the chairs, my feet are like this. So when I do a Cossack stretch, my feet are like this, not like this, okay? So, and keep the body upright. Also getting calf stretch here, and of course the groin is getting stretched. And you do that two ways. One, the one down here, and then this one being pushed out. So sort of a feel thing. There's no right or wrong way to do it as long as you're feeling it out. More three-dimensional, so do experiment and try things. Just kind of find the areas that are tight. Find the areas that say, hey, this feels pretty good, and just go for it. So every day, every stretch is just a little bit different. And okay. All right. Now I'm gonna, nice. Broke the light.
I turned the light off.
Like that.
It takes talent. You're like the new age Fonz.
So this is a mat. I'm about to do a pancake stretch on it, or something similar to that. So put the socks somewhere. In another video, I talk about stretching in the right clothing. You can click that link there to see it on the screen. There's actually no excuse why you should be stretching on hard ground. You want to do more reps with less stress. This is why successful tricksters have always tricked on plyo floor. This is why tricksters who primarily trick on plyo floor get more high quality reps in, that, so when they go trick on grass, they're better than the tricksters who trick exclusively on grass. You need to train in a way where you can get the correct response in, the correct training response, without unnecessary stress. And so, when you're training your flexibility on hard ground, you're gonna bruise up your knees and your ankles. It's just not gonna feel good. You're gonna have trouble sliding into the position. You wanna be able to slide into the position. Here's an example. I have a squat rack, you know, a foot and a half from my butt. Okay? If I'm walking through my house, I might go, hey, I can do some squats. I'm gonna jump up the squat rack and do some squats, you know, because it's convenient. It's right there, it's easy to get into. If you had a mat sitting on the ground in your living room or something, you're gonna walk by it and go, hey, I can sit on it and do some stretches. You're not gonna be walking by hardwood floor and be like, oh, fuck yeah, let's do some stretches on that hard ass floor, you know? You're not gonna do it. And you may think you're being hardcore for training on something like that, but you don't realize that over the long term, you're not taking every opportunity you can to train. If you had something just to give you a little bit of comfort, like this pad here, this is fucking $30 on Amazon. There's no excuse why you can't have it. Then you're gonna feel pretty good. Then you're gonna train it more because it's comfortable, it's easy, it's convenient. So, all right now, I'm not like doing any like contractions. I'm just kind of like, I'm not even as far as I can go down. I just kind of comfortable. And I'm going to sit here for, I don't know, 20, 30 seconds more or something. So it's just kind of easy. This is a throwaway set. What I mean by that is I'm not trying to live up to any sort of expectation I have of myself of how far I can go down. Instead of just going to a comfortable position and throwing the set away. So basically I'm not relying on this set to help me warm up. It's just kind of like, I'm intentionally lazy right now. Let's just put it that way. I'm intentionally being a puss about this and not going all the way down. And I'm doing it for a longer period of time. And what's going to happen is I'm going to get out of this, I'm going to rest 3 more minutes by taking a nap in the bedroom, and I'm going to come back and do this. I'm going to be able to go a lot further down. So it's not like, you know,
greasing the wheel.
Yeah, it's greasing the wheel, greasing the groove. Tell me about that. I know what greasing the groove is. I've never heard of greasing the wheel.
The same thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So there's more going on here than I think. Just because I'm not, like, forcing it doesn't mean I'm not getting results. So that's it. Always come out of your stretches slow, like a cripple. Gentle. What is it? 35? 35-10? Alright. Let's take another break. Alright, back to it. Same thing. Was that a little deeper?
A little bit.
This is still sort of a throwaway stretch. In a minute here, I'm going to have to start straightening up my body, and then that's going to put more pressure on this muscle in the hip. That's one of the reasons why a lot of people can't do this high split, is they think they have like a genetic default or a genetic defect or something. It's like, oh, my hip structure doesn't allow me to do this high split because this muscle right here always, you know, these bones get in the way right here. No, actually, it's just because it fucking hurts and you got to get through it. So. Sorry, there's no way around it, so it hurts to keep it upright like this, whereas, you know, when it's like this, it's relaxed. So there's one thing you can do. Sometimes it helps, sometimes it doesn't. It's pretty simple. That's so much fun. All right, behold my drawer of balls. All right.
That's where you keep them.
I want this. Yeah, I have lots of balls. Big balls. Big. All right, so this is a crystal ball. It's going to tell me. I don't think it's working. It's not showing me anything. I have to invent my own future. Okay, so if sometimes it helps and sometimes it doesn't, it's basically just sit on that muscle and that's it.
Make love to the floor.
Yeah, make love to the floor. It's really inconvenient to do, but sometimes if you do that, it will kind of alleviate a little bit of the pain in that front hip muscle when you're doing the side split upright. Sometimes it doesn't. Right now I'm just going to do it because I'm telling you that it's something you can do and I have to show you. So here I am.
It's a great opportunity to pretend you're a mermaid.
Is that a mermaid? Ow! Be careful if you're a man, you have junk. You don't want that. Ah, there, I found it. Whoa, I feel it all the way down my toe. I feel it all the way down my big toe in that same leg. Holy shit. Ah. Okay. Do it as much as you want. That's as much as I want to do. Alright, so. Get back to this because I haven't done it in a little while. I have to do this the whole time. Just a little bit of refresher here for the body, hey. Reminding you. Ah, stay loose. Alright. Having fun.
Yeah. Why are you so sweaty?
Well, what do you mean why am I sweating? I'm moving, you dickhead. All right, get back to this. this one. Now I'm just kind of feeling it out. Feels pretty good. Set real quick before I start my real warm-up. This is my Jujimufu bird warm-up. I have to make room in my living room for this. So Cora, I'm gonna stick your stuff in your bag here. Alright. I love it. I had to have it. Every time. I have to do this shit every time. Because I don't have a cool place to do this yet. Sam has had that since she was a little girl. I don't know the story behind it. Dinosaur.
Whoa.
Oh, that's fruit snack. That's our pet.
That's cool. It's a piggy bank.
Well, yeah, it is. Cool. Welcome to my home. All right, I'll handle the couch in a second. So that was my rest period, I suppose.
Active rest.
Sort of, yeah. Now, here's the test. This is how you actually stretch for your side split, okay? This is how you actually practice the side split. Once you get a chair, you're good.
It's like you get a bump
chair,
something.
Okay? You have to have a chair. Preferably, you face it, facing it, okay? If you sit in this chair naked, if it's one you sit in naked all the time, it's not good because I'm about to have my face close to the seat. And if you sit in it naked a lot, you will smell your butthole. So, just something to know. Alright, so, I'm going to keep my legs upright. Push my hips forward. So, the bird dogs, I'm going to have to do some more of those in a second because I feel like I need that. Push your hips forward. Socks on sliding floor so you can slide out. Back upright. Okay, so this is what all the thoracic extension is for. And I slide down. I grab right here, I relax, and I keep my hips close to it, just like that. Alright. So this is just the first set. I don't feel that great right now, but I'm not going to panic because it will get better. You do this in sets and reps. And a rep is a hold like this, and a set has a rest period, so... Now, I can combine this with an isometric contraction, so it's kind of like I'm gripping the floor here. Like I'm flexing, I am pulling myself up. Relax, relax, boom. Contract, relax, relax, contract. Upright, relax. And then I'm gonna relax a little bit longer in a spot that's not all the way down. So just right there, completely relax. And then that's plenty. Oh. FYI, this stretch is useless.
but it's my favorite.
Because it's easy. You like easy things, Corey. You like easy women, right?
Who doesn't? I'm not much of a looker, Juju.
Oh, okay. Reveal yourself, cameraman. Show them who's filming. Is it all making sense now? What is it? 47? All right. Let me shake it out here for a second. Oh, the couch. I gotta move the damn couch. Fuck, where's this gonna go?
Overhead.
Okay, I have an idea. Overhead, press the couch. Usually I film from over there. Now, this, since I got a cameraman instead of a tripod, you'll be able to film from somewhere else. The groin hurts. I feel my groin! This is how you become famous on Instagram. You go through the trouble.
This is Karate Kid training.
Yeah. Alright, so. Do this again in a second. I'm actually releasing a pants product in the next couple months. By the time this video is online, it might be out. I don't know yet. So, these are currently made by Tanega. It's a company that went out of business. I know the owner, Brian, and we have been working for 6 to 8 months now on resurrecting these, changing the colors, the zippers, the cuts, the links. They're very proprietary. There's nothing else like them on the market. They're good for training flexibility because, well, they're stretchy, they give in the right place, but one of the cool things is when you're in a split, they have this kind of stretch right here that actually makes it look like you're going deeper than you really are. Little trade secret there, if you do the chair splits and shorts, it doesn't look as good as if you have these pants that stretch at the bottom that doesn't show you that maybe you go a little bit further, and then you can see the quads real good because They're perfect pants for training the splits and for showing them off. So, get you a pair. If there's a link that appears right here in the video, it's out or not or whatever. So, here we go again. This is set number 2. Up. Boom. All right. Notice I just used the chair, that one, just to kind of help me, and then I just let go, and I was able to align. Before you can get to that point, you have to use the chair to guide you every time. So always, always, always use the chair. Do not train the side splits without a chair. All right, we're getting close.
Finally.
What? I told you it'd be about an hour. 51 minutes, man. This shit takes me forever to warm up. Alright, next trade secret, elementary school chairs. The best chair to do this on. First of all, the floor is wood, so it slides. Second of all, these have metal bottoms, which slide. Third, they were made during an era where they overbuilt everything. Everything was overbuilt with too much plastic or steel, so they're sturdy as hell. Second of all, look at that. That's for my left leg. And this one? It's for my right leg.
Which one's for your third leg?
Bend over.
Oh, God.
when I was doing these, practicing them, I noticed that certain ones slid a certain way better than the other one, and then I just realized that they had to be, they work better if you figure out which one is which. So that's what I did, is I just figured out that one's for my left and that one's for my right. There's two ways you can enter the chair split, okay? So the first way is if you're not doing it with weight, you can do it this way. You can spread the chairs out, okay? Use something to hold. Find your spot. Your spot. Okay. I made a mistake. I'm not supposed to be wearing socks. I'm usually focused on training, not demonstrating, so I'm doing both right now. Boom. Boom. Alright, take my shirt off too. Alright, now we can see where it is. Here, since I'm on sliding floor, I can kind of, I don't have to be exact, basically find it. There we go. Cheers. This is how you get out. That's it. This is fancy. Let me teach you something real quick. Not many people do this stunt because, you know, not many people do. But let me show you something. If I were to do it and my legs were back here and they were supported here, that's cheating. That's cheating, all right? This not only looks better, but it's a lot harder. So anyone who wants to challenge me on this stunt, if you aren't doing it like me, with the feet flat, and your feet is the only thing in contact with the chair, you're not doing it like I am. If you have blocks at a CrossFit box that are supporting you up to here, you are not doing what I'm doing at all. You're being a puss, okay? You have to do it like me. Feet are the only thing in contact with the chair. Not that. Not that. This. Only this. And keep your feet flat. If you're doing that, it's not the same thing. Okay? All right. Now, in a second, I'm going to start, like, getting in the zone here.
That's my water.
Oh, crap. Did I just get, like, hepatitis or something? I mean, what is it that spread through the mouth? Which one is it?
Yeah, it's hepatitis.
Fuck. Well, I don't have it, so you're clean. All right. So, when I'm starting to get, like, to that point where I'm starting to, like, you know, I start to be less social, I guess. I do this shit by myself, so I'm just kind of, like, you know, feeling it out. I am going to want one of these in a bit. Ammonia inhaling. I'm going to go ahead and set up the weight. I'm going to do this barbell overhead. So this is a 15-pound bumper plate. It's rubber, so when it hits the floor, it doesn't break. This is why you get a first-story apartment. Be on the first floor. Because if I had chosen a second floor, I would have been kicking myself in the butt because I wouldn't have this rack up there, that's for sure.
Well, you might end up on the first floor anyways.
Yeah, exactly. All right. Nice. That was a good one. There's 100 pounds. All right, so with the plates and the bar and the lock, it's 100 pounds total. Oh boy. put another hole in the wall. Alright. I'm still not ready for this. I still got another set here in the chairs. Set that there though.
I think so. I could have lied to you. I don't know.
Doesn't matter. All right, so when you're doing it without weight, you can have them apart and then use the set. Throw it away and then you're good. It's actually easier. When you're doing it with weight, there's no way I can grab that weight when I'm out here. It's not going to work. So I have to start with them close together. So that's too close. It's about right there. All right. It's pretty easy to feel out. All right. Again, the feet are not out here. They're here. And in fact, there is an advantage to doing it right. When my feet are here and I push out, the chair actually pushes out. If they're here, it wobbles more. It doesn't have a path. I control it better when the feet are closer to the edge like this. All right, so again, upper back still loose from all those thoracic extensions upright. Hips pushing forward. The pain in my hips, I just have to fucking ignore it. It hurts like hell. And then just when you go out for the first time like this, you will notice that one of the legs tends to slide out. One of them will stop, but the other one will keep going. That's fine. It happens a lot. So, and go. Do it this way. I mean, I guess you could. It makes more sense to warm up by doing a lighter weight. But I feel like if I can get the pattern right just with my body weight, I can jump right up to the weight. So I'm just going to do it the first time with the weight after I get this through. So I need another rest period because my groins, you know. You need rest periods not just because you're out of breath. I'm not really out of breath. I'm talking a lot. That's why I'm out of breath. But you need rest periods because of your nervous system and your muscular cells are calibrating themselves to a stretch response. So there's a lot going on in my pants right now. There's a lot going on in my pants right now, and it needs time to happen. So I'm looking at that clock over there. It's an hour. So come over here. So it's been an hour, all right? It's taken me an hour from the time I started cold to about now when I'm about to start the stunt in about 3 or 4 minutes, so. I haven't checked my phone today. Or in a while. You want a little bit of chalk? Even though it's not that much weight on my wrist.
It's for the groin.
Yeah, the groin needs to talk. Oh! Yeah. When I was performing for America's Got Talent, I actually had liquid chalk. I put that shit all over my feet. It helped, dude. I needed it on that floor.
I don't understand liquid chalk.
You never heard of liquid chalk? You're pretty good. Again,
I just use hairspray.
More of a comfort. Hairspray and a lighter. I'll make your feet fast. Alright, where are we at? Alright, so we're gonna have 2 or 3 minutes before I do this. Let me find a song.
Thong song, Cisco.
Thong song. draw enough attention to myself in this fucking apartment. I draw enough attention to myself. There has to be a certain sense of censorship, right? Alright.
Probably better straight ahead. Might be able to get behind the couch.
Yes. Stand up there. That's pretty cool. Yeah. You want to stand on that?
I don't want to break nothing. What is this?
Don't stand on it.
I didn't think so. Okay, I was just making, that's why I was asking.
Here. Straddle. There you go. All right. Fuck yeah, man. Never had a cameraman for this. This is a luxury. Fuck yeah.
Alright, touch the butt. Ooh.
Okay, good.
Aggression. Oh God.
Ah!
Yeah.
Ah! Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Whoa! Yeah. Oh. Life is good. How'd it look? And that's it. That's how I do my way to chair split. And I don't want to do it again. I think one's enough for the day. So, thank you, Corey, for following me around. Keep five. And, that's my way to chair split between you. Thank you for watching. I hope you got some cool tips out of this. All right. Yeah?
All right.
All right, man. Go for it. Hold it. Dude. Looks good to me. Dude, you fucking owned it. What?
I did it?
Yeah, dude, that was it.
Oh, shit. I felt like I was up here.
No, dude, you fucking owned that shit.
feet are cramping.
It's my feet are trying that hard to stay.
Yeah.
From trying to do this.
It's fucking perfect, dude. All right, so what's helping you here?
Moving, honestly. A lot of the stuff that you were teaching over at the Fit Expo, using squats, just weighted squats, helping to strengthen these things. Understanding that strength and flexibility are almost the same thing. Your body's usually strong enough to handle what you're throwing at it. However, your brain doesn't understand that you are indeed able to handle a range of motion. So using squats and Cossacks, side to side, weighted Cossacks, whatever, using strength to help teach your brain that you are indeed flexible enough to do things like that.
Yeah. Yeah, good job, Corey.
First time.